study.
Everyone loves a good story. So stories of heroes, damsels, tragedies, curses, and even prophecies. We have heard a lot of myths and legends in our lives because there are a lot of references of them in pop culture today, like in games, books, and movies. So why do I tell you that there are some characters from these myths and legends that are actually real? And next slide. So I've been sharing with you today three historical figures who turned into folk wars, next, who are Imhotep, King Midas, and Shamu Raman. Next. So the first character is Imhotep. He was famously depicted in the movie The Mummy. So as a summary of the movie, of the character, there's a mummy who emerges from the dead to wreak havoc on the earth and to resurrect himself. So basically, he was the antagonist of the film. However, the figure portrayed in the movie was so much different than the original person. In real life, he was the chancellor of Pharaoh Zoser, the third pharaoh of the second dynasty. And he was responsible for building the Zoser pyramid. He was also known as the first physician, as he treated many diseases and may help establish the first known medical school. During the late period, his worship turned into excessive admiration from the people, and he became a local god in Memphis as for praise for his skills as a physician and a healer. So in an article all about Imhotep by Queen Armstrong, he was associated with the Greek god of medicine, Asclepius. So before going to the next slide, I think a lot of people might know who is the second historical figure is because he's quite famous. I'll actually give you a quick summary of this character, of the story. So have you ever heard of a king who actually has the power to turn everything he touches into gold, and in the end, accidentally turning his daughter into a golden statue? So next character we have, yes? Surprisingly, King Midas was actually a real person. He was actually a historical king in ancient Kingdom of Phrygia. So as referenced in Assyrian and Greek sources, he was possibly the last independent king of Phrygia, as his kingdom had suffered a major military defeat against the Sumerians. So you might be wondering, why is he associated with the golden touch? There are two explanations for this. First is to show the wealth of the Phrygians at the time, and King Midas himself. Because Phrygia was a very fertile land with a lot of valuable resources, well, especially gold. That's why it's associated with golden touch. Secondly of all, and it's mostly speculation, but the second one, is that Phrygians usually love to wear golden-like garments. They love to wear golden-colored garments, although they don't really have much gold. That's just speculation. Because as archaeologists have found in samples of garments in the tomb of Midas, they found that the samples of the garments contain a yellowish pigment of iron oxide in the samples of garments, giving the garments a gold-colored look. Okay, so lastly is the third character, next, which is Shamu Raman. Okay, so she is a person appointed to govern the Neo-Assyrian Empire until her son reached the age of maturity. When her husband died, she ascended to a throne and was able to provide the stability that's needed for her country. She was also successfully launched a military campaign against Greeks and Persians. Her successful reign gained her great adoration from her people and led to the worship of her as a mythical queen called Semiramis, the myth. So as her historical counterpart, Semiramis conquered much of Asia and also is responsible for going to Babylon and constructing very famous architecture of the world. Although in another name, Semiramis still established his legacy as one of the earliest and most accomplished female monarchs of her time. In conclusion, these historical figures are folklore, mostly for Indians. Although their story and fabricated myths, their legacy is still remembered and passed down from generation to generation to this day. So next, that's all for my presentation today. Thank you for listening.